Google Fonts is awesome. You can browse through thousands of font families, filtered on supported languages, the style, you can preview your own copy. But you should never use the fonts you select by bringing them in with the Google CDN, which is how most of us do it. Just copy this, paste it in the head of your HTML, and done. You've got your fonts, use them as you please. But at what cost? There is a cost. This is objectively a mistake, and I will explain why. But first, here's what we should be doing instead. We should be self-hosting the fonts, which we can do in a couple different ways. Traditionally, we download the fonts, figure out how to serve them from the same domain as our website, and declare them in a way to avoid layout shift and other gosses, but that is much more of a hassle than pasting a couple lines of code. No worries though, we live in a future where we have hassle-free ways to self-host. Next.js has a bespoke solution for font optimization, but here's a solution we can use with any framework, including our darling SvelteKit. We'll use Fontsource, which publishes all Google fonts and other open source fonts as NPM packages. We can still use Google Fonts to browse and identify the fonts we want. I find fontsource.org workable but clunkier. Either way, let's say we decide on Epilogue as our sans serif no-frills font and Tourney as our display fun font. Armed with that knowledge, let's go to the terminal, to the root of our project, and install those fonts as dependencies. We can use any package manager we want, npm, pnpm, whichever. I'll go with the flavor of the month, bun. So bun add dev dependency fontsource variable epilogue and fontsource variable tourney. Next, we have to import the font CSS into our code. For SvelteKit projects, for fonts we want to use throughout our app, we do that in our root plus layout.svelte. If you don't have one, create it in source routes, and in its script block, first thing we want is import the packages we just installed. Import font source variable epilogue, import font source variable tourney. And that's it. This has been the equivalent of pasting the Google stuff. We can now use our fonts anywhere in our app, but without the cost. So here in our layout, in a style block, we can say we want our default font to be epilogue by declaring HTML, font family, epilogue variable, fallback to sans serif. You can see this font applied the moment we save. Awesome. And maybe we want all our headers to use tourney. Font family, tourney variable, falls back to sans serif. Great. Let's apply a different font weight as well. Fun. When using channel favorite Tailwind, the process is very similar. We install our fonts the same way. I'll go old school this time with npm for the lulz.
3 hours later.
We import them in our root layout.svelte, in its script block, same way as we did before. But now we diverse. Now we go into our Tailwind config to declare that our sans font is epilogue variable, falls back to sans serif. Tailwind applies the sans font as the default everywhere for us, so we can indeed already see epilogue in our preview to the right as soon as we save. We can also specify our display font, tourney variable, falls back to sans serif, which we are now able to apply with the font display class. If we want to do the same trick as before, where all our headers use our display font automatically, we can go into our app CSS, and we can specify that in the base layer, for all our heading elements, we want to apply font display. And even font thin or font 250, if we want an arbitrary value for the font weight. Some bonus Tailwind magic to finish with a flourish. Tailwind or vanilla, the core of the matter is the same. Instead of pasting the Google link tags, we install our fonts as dependencies and import them. To me, as a developer, that's about as convenient. But why is it better for our websites, for our users? What's wrong with the Google way? The biggest practical reason, the one you tell your product owner, CDO or similar stakeholder, is that the Google way harms your SEO and the user experience. Big companies pay big money for performance and SEO audits, and the most common feedback after those rigorous and expensive assessments is you should self-host your fonts. The Google CDN, as fast as it may be, is still a request outside your domain. This means we need to resolve the DNS for the Google CDN, then form the connection, then make it secure, then actually ask for the font file, then load it, and then finally render it. The pre-connect hint makes some of that process start happening earlier, but you know what's faster than earlier? Never! Skip the extra hoops altogether, get the font files from where you are right now. The Google way is the long way, which sets you back in a lot of metrics, such as first contentful paint, and even core web vitals, such as largest contentful paint and cumulative layout shift. Google themselves have decided these are the metrics correlating with a better real-world user experience, and therefore use them as a ranking signal for displaying search results. Let's rephrase that to ensure it lands, as it's so important. Google thinks your users will have a better experience when your website is doing well on those metrics, and will rank you better in search results. With that knowledge, it's your responsibility to eliminate the third party when it comes to your fonts. Get better metrics, better UX, better SEO. Happy users, happy clients, happy days. And there is even one more cost of doing things the Google way, although only if you care about privacy. Google remains an ad company above all. They profile everyone as much as they can and use that data as they please. So you bet when your users make a request to the Google CDN to get your fonts, they also get profiled a little bit more. Oh, they were on that website, using that device, they loaded this font. Interesting. However, I can see people dismissing this cost. Maybe they think Google already knows everything. Maybe the website is using Google Analytics, so every user is heavily profiled anyway. On the other hand, we do seem to be getting a bit more privacy conscious over time. Next.js highlights no requests are sent to Google by the browser twice in their font optimization docs. So they think developers want clear assurance on that front. I myself pay to use Plausible Analytics instead of the free Google Analytics, and there's a lot of other privacy-friendly analytics alternatives. If a market like that is viable, to me that's evidence enough people do care about privacy. But again, I can see this privacy creepiness angle being dismissed as just like your opinion, man. So I would always lead and focus on the practical reasons to dot Google fonts and self-host instead. As a principal software engineer, people often pay me to tell them, it depends. There is a lot of nuance behind every technical decision. Advantages, disadvantages, but this one really is a rare silver bullet. Just do it. I guess if I had to list a disadvantage, I would say that there is a higher chance to mess it up. There is a higher chance to spend more time and get things wrong when self-hosting than when pasting the Google links. But experts say, the more you watch and share this video, the lower that chance gets. To increase your chances of having fun with CSS and admissions, watch these videos right here. In any case, thanks a bunch for watching this one. I'll see you around.